I think Devontae Parker is pretty good. You know, I think a lot of people were talking about, oh, Miami, they really needed to improve their receiving core last year. And they did. I mean, there were some issues there, and they have done that to their credit. Very good job. Will Fuller, Jalen Waddle, big fan of both of those players. But I also still feel like Devontae Parker is very good, and he's definitely going to be a valuable asset moving forward. He even was good last year, even though it was, you know, about 750 snaps. So like on this play, this is a great example of one of the things that he does very well. So what's going to happen on this play is it's zone coverage, and I would say he's kind of a zone coverage killer. And part of that is just, I feel like being tall, it helps you against zone. It just does, especially when you can move like Parker can, and it can help you for this very reason. So you have, you know, zone coverage, cover three. The number two receiver, who isn't Parker, the one who I don't have circled, he's running a deep route. This pushes the safety deep. You then have Parker, you know, run a little bit underneath, and basically with the safety deep, he can get open. The way this play could fail would be if a Seattle defender sort of in front reads it and can kind of, you know, get into the way. But again, this is where Parker's height comes in. Because, like, watch, right when this play starts, I mean, you notice how. So at this point, it's pretty solid defense from Seattle. I mean, you know, he's kind of in the area. And I'm not saying this is only a height, but this is just a big part of it is being a big target. You want to give your quarterback as big of a target as you can to hit. That's what you want to do ideally. And now for Fitzpatrick, he now has a bigger target to throw to. And watch, as you see, it was a well-timed throw from Fitzpatrick as well, but even if it wasn't, I think Parker still makes that catch. He's really good in zone for that exact reason. He just gives you a big target to hit. It makes things easier. It'll absolutely make things easier for Tua next year when he's going up against these teams that play a lot of zone. He'll have plenty of success. If we're going to talk negatives, because I always try to talk about both sides, this is the only real one I have, is I'd like to see him be a bit more, you know, be a bit more polished with his route running, and really not just polished, but just attempt more moves, you know, try to fool people. It seems like basically every time he runs a route, it's just him running the route. He very rarely will do it. He will sometimes, but he very rarely will, and he could do it a lot more because he is a pretty good route runner when he's like trying. So on this play, it's zone coverage, an extra man dropping back in the coverage. And really, you know, a lot of guys would kind of do something where they fake a stutter running over the middle, maybe fake a stutter running a go route or something. That's not what Parker does. As you see, he's just going to kind of box him out, use that big body, and he's able to make the catch. So again, it works, and this is something that works for him, but I do wonder if he could just use it more often. I'm not saying he has to every single play, you know, go crazy with it, because again, he can use his size to his advantage, he can use his strength to his advantage, and he can use that good speed and on his first step, that good acceleration to his advantage. All of that stuff is great. But like, watch something like this. This is a great example of kind of what I'm talking about, and when he does make a move, he usually makes great moves. And this is going to show two points, so it's going to build off that last point, but show a new point. So I really want you to watch two main things on this play. It's going to be how he is going to fake as though he's doing something else before running over the middle, and then what he's able to do after the catch. Like, watch. Fakes as though he's going to his right, then gets to the left, so he gets more open, and then watch him be able to move, you know, really well and gain a lot more yards. And typically when a guy's able to get yards after the catch at his size, it's usually just like other players can't bring him down, but he's able to use that footwork to make it difficult. So good footwork when he uses it, and I just like to see him do that stuff a little bit more because he's really good at it. And I think that maybe, you know, with some pressure getting taken off of him, he will do that stuff more. I don't know. And now let's talk about something like this. So I talked about him being a zone coverage killer, but that's not me saying he can only win against zone coverage. I mean, we all remember that Week 17 game against Stephon Gilmore, where he really just dominated Gilmore that entire game. That was mostly in man coverage. So he can win against man coverage. This play is one against man coverage. It's going to be a cover one man play, and you see his route. It's just a one-on-one matchup on the outside. Very simple. And watch how right when this play starts, he has the speed to get the corner to turn around. And once you do that, once the corner has turned his back to Parker, he's probably making that catch. And I know it bounced out at the end there. It was ruled a catch and then an out-of-bounds fumble. So was a catch right there. And more importantly, I'm just talking about the way that he can get open, the way he can go up and make the grab. He is great at contested catches. And a big part of that is he gets corners to have to sort of turn around because he does have a great first step, really good acceleration. And then obviously he's big enough that he can go up and make the grab. And one more thing I want to talk about. This is another thing that I do consider a positive, and it's something I sometimes even look for when we're talking about these bigger receivers. Because again, You know, that's a big part of what his game is being 6'3 and being bigger than you. That's a huge part of his game. And it works. And that's all that matters, is how well does something work. So it's going to be man coverage, one-on-one matchup, similar situation to last time. And watch what he's going to do this time. So right when this play starts, really the main thing I'm going to want you to watch is, you know, it's somewhat of a similar situation to last time. But again, he's not just running it's not just going to be you throw it deep. It's going to be kind of more of a back shoulder-y throw. And because of this, he wants to make sure he can get some separation. And one thing that Parker is good at, and this is something that I do consider a skill, is knowing how much contact you can get away with. Watch this just little push, turns back, makes the catch, gets the ball inside the 20. That's a really good play, I think. And Parker can do stuff like that pretty consistently. So the fact that he can consistently, you know, find ways to make these types of catches, he can beat man, he can beat zone, I think he's gotten pretty underrated. I think there's a lot to like about Parker. If you look at his numbers, he certainly had a wild start to his career. I mean, you know, the first 4 years of his career, it was the constant joke of, when is he going to have his breakout season? It's finally going to come next season. And it's because you always saw the flashes. And every season he's played, there's always been some flashes. I mean, you look at his long for the season, and every year he's had a 30-plus yard catch. And in a lot of these years, he's had 40 or 50 plus yard catches. So the fact that he gets a lot of those big plays, that's already noticeable, and he can get the smaller stuff as well. And again, I mean, you can talk about consistency if you want to. 6 seasons, only one season with over 800 yards, although that one season was really dominant. Maybe you could argue, Fitzpatrick, he just throws up a bunch of YOLO balls, so yeah, Parker's going to catch some of those. You know what else you could argue? You can make the argument that he's been stuck as a number one receiver for a lot of his career, and in doing that, you're going to get really good corners to go up against you. One, clearly he would be, you know, anyone would be better if you take some pressure off of him. Now you have Waddle, you have Will Fuller. Hopefully Will Fuller will stay healthy, because obviously that's been a concern. But if this receiving core is healthy, I think Parker as a number three option is insane. I don't think he will be. I think he'll be the number two option, and maybe even to start still the number one option, because he does have a lot of talent. That's what I think. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. What are your thoughts on Devontae Parker? Always love hearing from you. And of course, as always, thanks for watching.